Hello, cloud gurus. I'm Mattias Andersson. This month, GCP does the hokey pokey to move data around, and although really that's what it's all about, we also have the Cloud Digital Leader certification going mainstream, new row-level security in BigQuery, Global Cloud DNS for GKE, all this and more right here on GCP this month. But before we jump into the news, a very timely announcement. We at A Cloud Guru are putting on a free community summit on June 28th to 30th. From noon to 4 p.m. Eastern time each day. So if you're watching this before then you still have a chance to participate and maybe even snag some swag. Follow the link in the description to learn more about GCP, AI, DevOps, AWS, Azure, and Linux. We'll have deep dives, hands-on challenges, live learning, and each day will end with a panel about cloud certifications, a couple of them including yours truly. So I hope to see you there. Did I already mention that it's all free too? Well, anyway, on to the GCP news. This month, I want to start with our gems. Now, I will admit that these announcements came in at the very end of May, but Google held their Data Cloud Summit after our press deadline, which is why we're including them in this June episode. First off, we have Datastream, a new serverless service to capture data changes and replicate them. This can be an amazing opportunity to unlock the value of data you have hidden away in various places, like Oracle and MySQL databases, and push it to cloud storage. But cloud storage is only an intermediary because data flow processing templates can take it from there to shuttle the data off to all sorts of different destinations, like BigQuery, Cloud SQL, Cloud Spanner, or MongoDB, for example. Then you can use that for low latency analytics or all sorts of DB replication situations. Or you could use the Datastream output as the basis for event-driven architectures. Just think about the possibilities with that, being able to extend your legacy systems with cloud-based change handling, all without having to change them. Anyway, Datastream truly is serverless. No servers in sight, and you only pay for usage. $2 per gigabyte of change data captured, and 40 cents per gigabyte of backfill data. Oh, did I not mention that yet? Yeah, it can also backfill historical data, not only track new changes going forward. Nice, eh? And you also get excellent control over the data scope, letting you pick and choose at the schema, table, and column levels, even handling future editions explicitly as either default to include or default to exclude. Seems like they thought of everything. So that's Datastream. Next up, we have Dataplex. Dataplex is Google's new offering, an intelligent data fabric, they call it, to centrally organize all the data lakes, data warehouses, and data marts you have spread across your enterprise. This lets you manage, monitor, and control them all. Plus, it makes it easier for you to apply artificial intelligence and machine learning to extract even more business value from them. If you see yourself in what I've just described, you should take a look at the links I've included in the description and sign up to be included in the preview. Google has also pre-announced their Analytics Hub, a new BigQuery-based platform to enable organizations to share their datasets with other external organizations, potentially even monetizing them in the process. Of course, we'll bring you more details on this in Q3 when we see something real. Now let's move on to this month's Quick Bites. All right, first off, I want to let you know that you can now book your Cloud Digital Leader exam. Google's entry-level certification is out of beta. Bookings opened up on June 21st, but the earliest exam date I've seen offered is June 30th. If you want more details about this certification, we'll include a link to our April episode where we cover them. And yes, Jim, I am still excited about this. Speaking of exciting, we now get HTTP 3 support for external HTTPS load balancing and cloud CDN. Most people use a browser that already supports HTTP 3, and I don't only mean Chrome, so they can start benefiting from its lower latency and higher throughput pretty much right away. Newly created load balancers will have this on by default, and there's a simple option to turn it on for existing ones, so be quick about it! If you're using Google Kubernetes Engine, GKE, you will probably be very happy to hear about Google's new container-native cloud DNS. I keep telling people that they really don't want to manage their own DNS more than they have to, and now you can have Google manage all of this in your clusters. No more in-cluster DNS pods, it integrates with the GCP operations suite, that's Stackdriver, and you get global cross-cluster service discovery for GKE services if you use the VPC scope mode. Fine-grained access control, or FGAC for those who like to pronounce the unpronounceable, is a valuable tool to achieve the critical security principle of least privilege. Well, BigQuery has just made their already very good FGAC even better. In particular, you can now control security of data in BigQuery at the level of each row. This in addition to the pre-existing control it already had at the levels of project, dataset, table, and even column. Very fine indeed. Another big announcement is for Bigtable. If you have a multi-cluster routing across three or more regions, Google now promises you 99.999% uptime. Multi-clusters without that much geographic distribution get 4 nines instead of the 5, and single clusters get 3 nines. But speaking of 5 nines of availability, let's talk about Cloud Spanner. Now in preview, you can size Cloud Spanner instances down to just 10% of their previous minimum. $65 per month is a much more reasonable starting point for the many GCP customers who, quote, have requested smaller instance sizes to support development, testing, and small production workloads, unquote. The new minimum still supports a very respectable 1,000 queries per second for reads and 200 per second for writes, though, so this is arguably still overkill for your neighborhood barbecue signup app. Now, if you're still running your own servers, you may be interested to know that Google has just released Ubuntu Pro Images for Google Compute Engine, GCE. These will receive bug fixes and security updates for 10 years after their release date, and the extra license costs are handled by GCE, so you don't need to worry about any separate subscriptions. Another announcement for GCE is the new Tau VM family, coming soon. These T2D VMs will use the latest 3rd-gen AMD EPYC processors and have full x86 compatibility. These come in at a very low price for the performance they offer, making them ideal for general-purpose scale-out workloads. Sounds epic. Okay, here's a fun thing I get to tell you about. PostgreSQL 9.6 is scheduled to be deprecated this November. No, that's not the fun part. Now, although you really should be upgrading well before then anyway, right? Google will actually be supporting PostgreSQL 9.6 on Cloud SQL for a full year after that. But you really should still take the time to upgrade to something newer though, like PostgreSQL 10 or 11 or 12 or 13. Yeah, version 9.6 is from 2016. Well, all right, let's keep this wrap up short and sweet. Don't forget to like and subscribe, check out our free trial for tons of cloud training, and I hope to see you very soon at our free online community summit. All the wonderful links are in the description below. Take care, stay safe, and keep being awesome, cloud gurus.